But it's a joy to see so many in preservation. The big one in front of me now, this is a ploughing engine. And years ago, instead of having a tractor, instead of having a plough, we used to have an engine inside of the field. If you look underneath it, you'll see a great big truck with a cable on it. And they used to put the plough on the end of the cable and pull it to one side of the field with one engine. And then the other engine at the opposite side of the field would pull it back again. And it was called a balanced plough. Those of you who've been to a ploughing match may have seen one working. It's six or seven furrows in the air, and on the other end of it, six or seven furrows in the grain. And these things just gradually move across the headland very slowly as the grain was cultivated. And of course it was a great saving in labour. A horse would only pull in reasonably good conditions one furrow at a time, whereas you could do five or six furrows at a time with one of those. Maybe more if the grain was good. So it's a big experience having one of those here. They usually come in pairs, you know, one each side of the field. But a tremendous amount of power from that that big engine on the top. Absolutely huge. Of course, one of the problems they used to experience was moving around the field. Being so heavy, if the grain was wet, they used to put double lugs on the wheels so that they would grip, and even then it was very difficult at times. A lot of these, you see some rollers, road rollers going around. They were used by municipal contractors to do road repairs and so on and so forth. Some of them have got some scarecrows on the back, which was a very long piece of metal they used to let down into the grain, and that used to rub up the old tarmac or the old road surface. And then they obviously would lay new, and then they'd roll it down. Of course, you're talking about 15, 16 ton in weight, so you used to do a good rolling job. You certainly wouldn't want to get your foot in the way. Although it was slow progress, they used to move a very large tonnage at a time. But you're only doing maybe 12 miles an hour at the most. If you were fully loaded, you'd be lucky if you got it late, maybe. But you must remember, it was a slower and quieter time than we're used to living in now. And it was a much slower pace, much slower. Engines are some very complicated valves here because they need to be controlled very carefully. You know, it's just got a very good energy sensor, and just a couple of things that you can do for you. You have a mixture of barrel engines, furrows and failures, enabling, Wallace and Stevens, all famous names at the time, but men are pretty much the same as we would know. Ford and Volkswagen today, these engines were well known at their time. So we've got a Ford steam tractor that's going to be here too at some point. See you again. The Ford plane engine, 1917, that was used. That was used during the First World War. We're used to seeing the modern developments on vehicles. The steering on these are steer by chain. Modern cars fly by wire. Things have moved on a bit, haven't they? Flywheel used to drive the threshing drums. These before the combine harvester. Hello Ian, nice to see you. That's kind of brilliant, brought this many times for us to see. It's a scale model. Still capable of an amazing amount of work. We come from Oaksea, which is local to us here, relatively. The other side of Malmesbury. How are you? You could creep up on anybody with that, you know. Yeah, quite. Now this, I understand, is a replica. Yeah, tell us a little bit about it, do you mind? It's a replica of a 1900 look.